Welcome na nga dito sa Star Cinema Chat at makasama na natin ang bida ng single single. Please welcome Mateo Gudicelli. Greet everyone muna.
Shaina, nasa bahay ka. Dapat nandito ka sa tabi ko. Joke. Hey everybody, what's up everybody in Star Cinema? Facebook, YouTube, everywhere else out there. Thank you very much and thanks for having me.
Yeah, so Matt, ito si Zoe Boy ka dito sa single-single, diba?
Yeah.
Kwento mo na ba kami about Zoe Boy dito sa movie na?
So I'm Joey Boy. So Joey Boy is, hey bro, who's that? Teka lang, where are you? Joey Boy.
Joey Boy.
So, single-single started season 1, season 2, now it's a movie. So Joey Boy, there's two characters, Joey and Joey. Joey Girl, Joey Boy, Shaina and I. And it started off with two strangers moving in a condominium together na hindi nila kilala yung isa't isa. As they move in and the relationship they build, so umpisa talagang they don't know each other, so they're like frustrated with one another. And then you know, sino maglilinis ng banyo, sino maglilinis ng kusina, ganyan. I'm sure as millennials, you guys can relate to this if you guys lived with a housemate or in college or something. Yeah. I personally relate to this when I went to college in the States. All my roommates were all strangers. At may mga roommates na talaga nakakainis, madumi, mga ganyan. So, parang nakarelate ng ganyan. So, it's about two people, two strangers living together and having a life together. So, season one, they start falling for each other. And then season two, may love story na sila. And the end of season two, nabuntis si Joey Girl. Kaso lang, nung sinabi ni Joey Girl, nabuntis ako. Joey Boy, sobrang tuwang-tuwa. Kaso lang, hindi sa kanya. Pero sa sobrang pagmamahal ni Joey Boy kay Joey Girl, sabi niya, I don't care, you know, whatever it is, I'll be your father and I will be the father of the kid. So that's how much Joey Boy loves the girl. And the movie, the title of this film is Single Single Love Is Not Enough, because sometimes, you know, some relationships, you put so much, you give so much investment, you give so much time, so much heart, so much passion, but in the end of the day, you say, you know, I love this person so much, but it's still not enough. Life is not single, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, I think a lot of millennials can relate to this film because it's really happening. It's really and it's talaga about millennials, kumbaga, you know.
So it's, yeah. Serious has itong movie ba yung will be the parang parang ito yung mag
go sure.
Yes.
But yeah, yun yung dapat abangan. No? We had so many shoots and so many reshoots to identify what would be our closing.
Yes.
Kung happy, sad, whatever. So abangan yung closing. The ending is very nice for the film. But you know, the message of the film is about millennials, about starting their own life, starting their own business. You know, a lot of millennials out there are very, they think they know everything right away. You know, that's a problem with millennials right now. It can be a positive or negative thing. And a lot of millennials get depressed very fast. And, you know, these are issues that are being addressed now with millennials, you know, depression and all this stuff. And I think the movie tackles a lot of this, you know, about never giving up, about starting your whole life, taking life seriously, how to deal with different social problems, issues in life. So, yun. So, makes sense?
Talaga. Kasi marami, parang, kumbaga, makaka-relate ka sa maraming bagay as a millennial. Kasi hindi lang to about, parang, love life, may career din to,
yeah,
di ba?
Yeah.
Sa series, kasi parang, may mga sarili-sarili rin kayong, parang, jobs.
You know, Joey Boy had a job before. He was an artist. He nagbabanda siya. He realized it wasn't going nowhere. As he opened a restaurant, it wasn't going nowhere. So he fell into depression. How he coped up with depression. So it's very nice. It's very interesting.
Very now then.
Very now. Because you know, bro, to be honest, a lot of what's below millennials, what's before, after us,
Gen Z.
There's a lot of issues of little kids, you know, and falling depression, suicide, etc., all these things. And before we didn't have, the cases were not as big as today, you know? So I think we have to, it's an issue we really have to address also that, you know, there's so many things to do, bro. You know, if you're sad, that doesn't mean life is over. There's so many things to do, you know? So, you know, little boys and girls wake up because life is big and life is a big future for everybody.
And okay? Keep going talaga, kasi marami talagang pwede.
Yeah, you know, all these challenges happen to the best of us. So, you know, we fall 100 times, we stand up once.
Ito Matt, ano masasabi mo sa whole journey ng single single? Kasi diba, it started as series and then now nasa big screen na siya. So, what can you say sa buong journey ng nyo?
It's very interesting because 1 and 2 was such a refreshing show. Mm. Single single kasi, it's not your typical teleserye.
Yes.
This one is really realistic. It really happens. We don't have a formula. We did not have a formula. we did not have to follow, oh, dapat ganito, dapat ganito. No, we really had, showcased what really happened, what really happens in a millennial life, what really happens in a, you know, a young adult's life. So, it's different. Some people like it, some people won't, you know, but I hope people, a lot of people can relate and learn from it.
Sure, yeah, na marami talaga makakarelate. So ito naman, kamusta naman yung working mo with the cast nito, kay Shaina, kay Anna, Brian, and JC?
Very nice, you know, Jace, this was, he wasn't yet a big star then, mm-hmm. single one or two when he came in, but now his career has been launched, mm-hmm. and congratulations to Jason. Si Anna Luna also, diba? Anna Luna's great, she's been winning so many, Best Actress Awards, she's been
great,
she's with Star Magic now, and Brian also is great, and Brian is such a good actor. If you watch him in Single One, Two, you really think he's gay, but in real life he's not. So ang galing niya. Sometimes I forget that very straight pala siya. Kasi galing niya. She's very nice. It's so nice to work with different actresses because everybody's so different.
Yeah.
And finally, I get to work with somebody a little more my age, but Shepherd, she's older. Because everybody I work with are like younger, diba? Liz Ked, or 20 years old, so feeling 20 din ako, and I feel my age with Shaina. So, it's nice to work with different partners all the time.
With, ano naman, mga directors, marami kayong directors sa single-single, diba?
Yeah.
There's Direk Ronnie, Direk Pablo, and Direk Pepe. So, kamusta naman yung...
Direk Pepe is our original talaga, single one, single two. It was very nice to work with him because he came from the TVC advertising indie field. It was very nice, very refreshing to work with him because his camera movements were all different, were very fresh, were very new, his ideas were very new. We had a lot of improv on the sets, you know, very fresh, very new. Derek Ronnie was a different kind of style also. We had lots of adjustments to make in the beginning because syempre, from one to two and then we go to a new director. But I think it was a nice adjustment also. It was nice to have a feel of a different director. But hopefully the edits and the whole film will be nice. It's just a different feel, though. No? I think we adjusted properly with her, and I think people will relate good with this film she made.
And working with different directors, parang siyempre, marami ka ng learnings, di ba?
Yeah.
Kasi iba-iba eh.
Yeah. I mean, you know, it's like a captain of a ship. Kapag bago yung captain, this captain has his own ways, and sometimes you have to adjust. So it's all about adjusting.
Okay, so ito, Matt, anong pinaka-mamimiss mo sa team single-single? Sa single-single family mo?
Okay. Oh, single one, single two, there's so much already missed. Kumbaga, you know, the camaraderie, the friendship. Mm-hmm. All our inuman scenes in this teleserye were real. Mm-hmm. And then we really got drunk and we did the show again and all this stuff. It was
so, totoo lahat yun.
Yeah, it was fun. So, kapag sasabihin nila yung mga audience na hindi ko tong lasing, hindi gagawin kayo, lasing talaga. but it was very nice. Dami mga miss because we built such a good camaraderie and team with our writer directly, Sir Lilith, and our new writer now, Jinky, and everybody's more of a family from the staff, Cinema One. It's also Philippine Star's first time to produce a movie. So it's a nice experience, it's a good learning experience for that.
Okay. So ito na nga first game natin, Mati, ang best and worst. So mag-share ka lang ng mga best and worst experiences mo. First na best travel destination for you?
Wow. Ah, New Zealand. That was the latest, no? Because I went to New Zealand. I think that the place was beautiful. Sobrang simple, sobrang linis ng hangin, sobrang bait ng mga tao.
Hindi pa ganong overpopulated sa...
So New Zealand was super beautiful.
Okay, so... Ito. Best childhood memory. Naaala ka pa ba ng kabataan mo?
Natuli ako.
Natuli ako.
Best childhood memory. I guess.
Robert,
yeah, with all the friends and.
Ano ang paborito niya lalaro siguro ng barkada mo before? I'm a mix sports bahay before.
Yeah,
bata ka.
There's so many things that I miss. I've been living in Cebu before with all my friends, and Cebu then was talagang so virgin, so no traffic, sobrang denta ngayon. The traffic's a mess. But before, Cebu was beautiful, no? Until now, but needs work. Kumbaga, yun, you know, the olden days when everybody was...
The simplicity of the day is
Yeah, it's nakakamiss talaga.
Okay, for you, Matt, ano ang best type of date?
Best type of date?
Yes.
I guess, unexpected, unplanned, unrehearsed date, something very casual, something very...
Spontaneous,
kumbaga.
Ito. Sino ang yung best friend?
My best friend?
Yes. Pwede siguro showbiz or talagang kahit ng showbiz?
I have a lot of best friends. I don't know. I consider a lot of friends best friends. So it's hard to say. Like example, from in my restaurant now, I have a best friend. Her name is Pisha. I'm always with her. When I make coffee, my best friend is, his name's Hans. When I'm in my racing, I have this best friend, his name's Ivan. When I'm, you know, when I'm in ABS, I have another best friend. So, everywhere I have a best friend. So, my boy.
Then you mentioned yung restaurant mo, di ba? So, ano yung parang, ano ba yung parang best seller mo? Yeah, parang, best seller.
So, you should come one day. Come one day and I'll be your waiter, I'll be your server. And, not one day, you have to come several times, you can try all the different things, you know. We have different stuff, man. We have everything in my restaurant. It's all home cooked. It's stuff I grew up with.
Yes.
And every 2 weeks in my restaurant, we have specials. So now, these 2 weeks, we have summer specials. Mm. So the theme of the summer specials is lemons from Amalfi. Amalfi is a little town in Italy, somewhere there. They have really big, fat lemons that are very nice. So we made a couple of dishes with that. I can tell you guys. So we have a nice pasta, aglio olio base with polpo. Polpo is like octopus. Mm-hmm. With lemon dressing on top. It's very nice, very fresh. Bagay sa heat. We have a nice pasta with a cream sauce, with a pasta called Gragnano. Gragnano? Yeah. It's a very special pasta. They don't make commercially. You can't buy this in the supermarket for sure. They make it in this town called Gragnano. Mm. They make it with bronze tools, and they don't sell it commercially yet. And it's very sophisticated. So all the high-end Italian restaurants around the world only uses Gragnano. So we're lucky for this month we've been using it. And then we have a Angus strip loin scaloppini. So the Angus strip loin scaloppini is marinated in butter and in Amalfi lemons, and it's strips of strip loin which comes from Argentina, Nico Bozico's farm. So there's no injections, there's no nothing. It's all fresh grass fed stuff. So you know people come in the restaurant and eat risotto and they say, "Oh, risotto is hilaw pa." My mind, ignorante ka, you know, like, risotto, guys. Let me give you a little lesson 101.
Okay.
No, it's not, you know, yeah, syempre. You know, it's like, how do you say? When you go to an Italian restaurant, you order risotto, if you want authentic, real risotto, it's not like Filipino jasmine rice, Japanese rice, where it's nice and soft. Risotto, there's like, it's al dente, so it's not hard, but it's a little stuff. Yeah, it's a little firm in the middle of the rice. Okay, so when some clients come in and they say, "Oh, it's undercooked," it's undercooked. Yeah, because it's hard. So it's not. It's really like that. That's risotto. That's Italian. So if you want to go to a Filipino Italian restaurant that makes it overcooked, they go. It's not Italian, right? So I have a lot of clients like that. So I mean, it's nice that you get to educate. You know, what is Italian, what's not.
But sabi na enjoy mo talaga yung pag-manage mo ng restaurant.
Yeah, parang showbiz.
Very hands-on, Very hands-on ka doon eh.
It's nice because, you know, you introduce people and to show them what's Italian food, you know? So, it's spaghetti that's not overcooked, maganya, it's not sweet sauce. So, it's nice also. But sometimes, I love Amber's with a hot dog.
Oh, yeah.
Sometimes. But my dad hears this, he's gonna kill me. So, yun.
Okay. So, ayun yung mga best mo. Ito naman, Matt, sa mga worst na mga experiences mo. Ano ang worst injury?
Worst injury? So, I got a hernia when I was 30. You know what a hernia is? Yeah. Like, close. But don't worry, I have two balls. So, I used to race horses before. When I was 10, 11, 10 to 12. And then, so my sister said, "Mateo, I can't use I can't use my horses. Their horse's name is Sultan. My horse's name was Luciano. Mm. My little horse was very nice. Her horse was nice, but she couldn't handle it. So sabi mo, "Tika, can you ride it?" So okay. Anyways, the horse jumped the fence this high. Mm. And when it jumped, no, like that high, not this high. That like 6 foot, something like that. Okay. So when it jumped, I landed on the neck. So the neck of the horse is a bone. So my nuts hit the bone. So I was shaking there, and then Papa comes there and says, "Mateo, do it again, go finish the course." Because you know, when you have an accident or something, or when you fall down, you have to do that thing over, you have to do it again. If not, you create a phobia. Mm. You'll be scared of doing it again. So right away you have to do what you did wrong and make it right.
Immediately.
Yeah. But you won't build that phobia. Because that's how fear generates your mind. But so I did it again. A few days after I had a soccer tournament, and healing pa dun magbo-boxers, di ba? Kasi kung brave na, hindi ka cool. So, boxers, pa-cool. So, sumasakit palagi, walang support. So, sabi ko, ano nangyari? It's after a week, namaga. And I showed Papa, I was 11, di ba? So I went to the hospital. After I showed the doctor, I said, "Mateo, I'm a hernia." I didn't know what it was. So, anyways, it's the edges thing going down, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah.
So, yun, I got operated and all that stuff. So, that's a memorable experience.
Worth nga naman talaga.
Was this before or after the tour?
This was after the tour. So, yeah, a lot of guys go through those things.
Lalo na yung mga talagang mga sports.
Yeah, that's why it's very important to wear supporters, especially lifting weights. Mm-hmm. So, my driver, his name's Edwin. A few weeks ago, he was in the restaurant. He was in the morning opening shift lifting the stuff. And then nagpitik daw yung itlog. He ripped his nut. So, it's very important. Lesson learned for you boys. Lesson learned, you really have to wear supporter.
And be careful talaga sa mga mga pagbubuhat na ganyan.
Yeah.
Okay. So from worst injury, punta naman tayo sa worst food you've tried. Hindi ko siguro in-expect na ganito yung lasa or ano ba?
Parang hindi lang tayo nag-live yun na, no?
Yes. Yes po. Yes
po.
Worst food you've tried, Matt.
Worst food I've tried.
Taka, kailangan mo magtubig dahil hindi mo in-expect na ganito yung lasa or...
I guess I don't know. Every cuisine is different. This so I cannot say it's bad or you know. It's just different. You can't say, "Oh, Kadiri, I'm never going to get it again." With the restaurant, I've learned to appreciate different dishes and to not diss a dish because you know if you diss a dish, it ruins its culture, its love. You know, it's some people like it, some people don't. I mean, you might like something, and I hate it, and I'm going to say it's the worst, but it's not fair. So what the worst thing I've tasted is like rotten milk. Sometimes I make coffee and then I open the thing and then I drink it and then after I drink like a whole glass, I find out it's rotten. Yeah, that's the worst.
Kasi yun talaga, as in, di ba?
Yeah.
Malalaman mo na lang pag natikman mo na.
Yeah, kasi, diba? Nakakainom ko na.
Okay, and then last, worst haircut or hairstyle you've got?
When I was 15, I was rocking mullet. So if you Google my old pictures, I long hair the back and short the side. Yeah.
Sa school ba before sobrang ano yung haircut ba?
Yes, sa school kasi bawal the best dito, diba?
Yeah.
So I had it short here but long in the back and then long in the front. So parang tangan.
Okay, so ito na nga ang first things first. First with Mateo. Para itong fast talk, Mateo. Anong una mo maisip pag narinig mo itong mga words na ito?
Okay.
Ready? Food.
Pasta.
Hollywood.
Brad Pitt.
Book.
Sexy Brad Pitt.
Yes. Book.
Book. The Man Who Sold His Ferrari.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Vacation.
Vacation. Cebu.
Acting.
Dolce Amore. I don't know why.
Superhero.
Lakas. Alakas. Lakam. Lakam at lakas.
Fashion.
Fashion. Ripped jeans.
Music.
Pop rock.
Sports.
Running.
Marriage.
I was about to say soon.
Oh my god!
Yeah, in the future.
Okay. Cars.
Cars. Van.
Workout.
Run. Running.
Country.
The Philippines.
Guilty pleasure.
Oh, are you sure? Okay. guilty pleasure. I don't know, ice cream. Sorry. Last night, I ate like, I was finishing, I was in the restaurant and we had Carmen, you know Carmen's Best ice cream?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So we had like Carmen's Best there. I ate like maybe 5 scoops of salted caramel.
Ikaw ba medyo ano ka sa diet mo?
No bro, I believe in eating anything and everything, just in moderation.
Saka talagang in-workout mo lang, diba? Okay, snacks!
Snacks! Wow. Fruits?
Beach!
Palawan.
Joey Boy.
Cool.
Sarah Geronimo song.
Kilometro.
And last, single.
It was an awesome journey. I hope
yeah. Okay, let's invite everyone on first singles.
Yes guys, my name is Mateo Celli. I'm playing Joey Boy in the movie, in the up-and-coming movie on May 2. Single, Love Is Not Enough. Produced by Philippine Star and Cinema One, distributed by Star Cinema. Please guys, May 2, single in theaters nationwide.
Yay! Thank you so much.